Hello, welcome to Bite Size Med. This video is on the structure of a typical vertebra. The vertebral column includes a series of bones extending from the cranium up to the apex of the coccyx, which is the last bone of this column. Each bone is a vertebra, and these vertebrae are divided into groups. Starting from the top, there are cervical vertebrae, then the thoracic vertebrae, the lumbar vertebrae, the sacral vertebrae, which fuse during life to form the sacrum, and the coccygeal vertebrae, which fuse to form the coccyx. Vertebrae in each section have unique features. Though it would be easier for us to study this if they all look the same, that probably wouldn't work out functionally. There's a reason for their differences. But most of them follow a similar pattern, a typical pattern. That's a typical vertebra, and that's what this video is on. I found the best way to study the vertebral column is to first learn how a typical vertebra looks, then the variations in each region, put them all together with the joints and ligaments in between, and then learn how they develop. This is part one, and it's on the structure of a typical vertebra. Assume this is a typical vertebra when seen from above. To understand it, we will need different angles, but this is where we're starting. This would be the anterior part, and this would be the posterior part. Posteriorly are the spinous processes, which we can feel as the spine. That's how you can tell which is the front and which is the back. From the side, these are two vertebrae, one below the other, and this would be anterior, and this would be posterior. Anteriorly, there's this chunk of bone called the vertebral body. The vertebral bodies stack up one beneath the other and are important for weight bearing. They are joined to each other by joints and ligaments. Most of the vertebral body is cancellous bone, and it's got marrow, red bone marrow. Cancellous bone is surrounded by a thin layer of compact bone. The rim of the vertebral body is smooth. Another term you'll see used for the vertebral body is the centrum. Though technically the two are not synonyms, so we'll reserve centrum for embryology. Now, posteriorly is the vertebral arch, which literally looks like an arch. This arch has got processes, and these processes form attachment sites for muscles and ligaments, and we'll get to those. But the vertebral body and the vertebral arch form the boundaries of a space called the vertebral foramen. The vertebral body forms the anterior margin of this foramen, and the vertebral arch forms the posterior and the lateral margins. When the vertebrae stack up, these spaces line up, forming a canal. That's the vertebral canal. What does the vertebral column protect? The spinal cord. That's what's in this space. The vertebral canal, and so the vertebral foramen, contains the spinal cord. The vertebral body is attached to the vertebral arch by two little bony pillars called pedicles. There's one on each side. From those pedicles, two sheets of bone extend posteriorly and then they meet in the midline. These sheets are called laminae. So two pedicles and two laminae. Now we get to the processes. From the junction of those two laminae, the posterior projection is called the spinous process. On either side, from the junction between the pedicle and the lamina, is a transverse process. One on each side. So that's one spinous process and two transverse processes. At the sites where the pedicles join the laminae, there are articular processes. Two above and two below. Better seen from the side. These are the articular processes. The one above is called the superior articular process, and the one below is the inferior articular process. They articulate with what? Each other. The superior articular process of one vertebra articulates with the inferior articular process of the vertebra above it. These are the articular facets, also called the zygapophyses. They form joints called the zygapophysial joints or the facet joints. This joint results in two notches between the vertebral body and the articular processes, the superior and inferior articular notches. They create a space between the vertebrae. It's a space, so a foramen. Between the vertebrae, so intervertebral. This is an intervertebral foramen. This is different from the vertebral foramen. That has the spinal cord. This forms spaces on the sides for the spinal nerves coming from the spinal cord to exit the vertebral column. So we have the vertebral body anteriorly, the vertebral arch posteriorly, and the vertebral foramen between them. The body and the arch are attached by two pedicles. From the pedicles, there are two laminae. Where they unite, there is a spinous process extending backwards. On the sides, two transverse processes and four articular processes, two superior and two inferior. A total of seven processes. That is a typical vertebra. In part two, we'll look at some of the variations that happen in each region. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, you can give it a like and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.